Alright, welcome back to Let's Play Birth by Sleep, Ventus' story. And we're probably horribly underleveled for this, but we're going to go ahead and try. And if we die, I will go back and do some leveling and, you know, come back later. But, I mean, I thought it was kind of interesting. I guess there's no point in giving my commentary right now because there's about to be a cutscene, so I will be right back.
Friends forever.
Interesting how in the Land of Departure, Master Eriquis was completely willing to kill Ven. And don't get me wrong, I understand the necessity of it. I understand what drove him there. I get it. I really do. But, that is still, Ventus as a whole is still a victim in this situation. He has done nothing wrong, and I understand the necessity of killing him. I'm not saying I don't understand Eriquis's logic, and Ven was showing to be a bit rebellious and like he was gaining an understanding of the situation that he didn't have before, so there was a likelihood that he could go rogue and he could become the Keyblade that was exactly what Eriquis did not want to happen. I understand all that. But rather than sitting down and giving Ventus a good long talk about the situation and what is happening, what is going on, he instead is like, okay, I'm gonna have to kill you. What the fuck kind of logic is that? Seriously. And don't get me wrong, maybe talking to Ventus wouldn't have changed anything. Maybe he still would have had to kill him. But you still give this child, basically, that you have helped from when he had amnesia and didn't know his butt from a hole in the ground. Like, you helped him. You basically raised him, and you here you are, ready to kill him without even a fucking explaining what is going on, what his life is, and how he is part of this big, horrible thing that he did not even want to be, that it was, he had no choice. We saw Ventus was willing to die instead of calling on the darkness in his heart. So doesn't that merit something? The darkness was forced out of his heart. The darkness was forced out of him. And while it may have developed a life of its own, while it may have done everything horrible you can imagine, that doesn't change anything. Ventus is still a victim. So, I don't know, I'm just kind of irritated. And to me, that kind of points into a gray area of, you weren't strong enough to actually beat. Shit. You weren't actually strong enough to beat the actual bad guy. So you take his victim. You decide to kill his victim, who's nothing more than a pawn in his scheme. Like, really? Really? This is the path of light. This is the good guy. Really? Rather than, I don't know, bringing Terra into the fold, bringing Aqua into the fold, actually explaining to them what the fuck is going on, you hide behind vague allusions to the terror that you feel. And act as though there's only one way this can be resolved, when that's a fucking lie. all you had to do was explain it to these guys. These three people, two of which were battling to become Keyblade Master, one who is a Keyblade Master now, by your own customs, she is a Keyblade Master, and you don't even tell her the full details of the situation. I just, I'm irritated. I'm irritated at Eriquis. Treasure rate is still finding strike. This finding strike is done. And since we're in the end game, let's see. Steep freeze. Where's deep freeze? Deep freeze. There we go. And let's meld a couple of commands and see if there's anything we can gain. Alright, let's try this. And then there's nothing else. So I will no doubt have to fight a few more battles like this. And I don't have a huge amount to say now, but I mean, those are kind of my thoughts on the situation. Yes! Master Xehanort is the big bad of the game. There's no real arguing with that. I mean, he has been the antagonist through and through. But I do think that there is something to be said for the Keyblade Masters of old who failed. Because that's what it was. It was a big fucking failure on their part. Shit, 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 shit. I hate this fucking, little timer fucker. It's annoying. I hate the camera in this place, too.
Thunder! Freeze!
Well, here, so maybe I won't fare too badly on the, yeah, I knew that was gonna happen. I won't fare too badly on the, final boss battles. Although you wouldn't think that level 23, although I am playing on easy mode, so. And this is why I play on easy mode, because I fucking hate grinding. I hate it with a passion. I love RPGs because they have the most intricate stories you can find in games, typically. That's not, you know, 100%. I understand that there are games that, you know, don't follow that. There's JRPGs that are light on story and they fucking suck. And then there's non-RPG games that have big intricate stories too. But I don't know, I tend to find the over-the-top qualities of RPGs entertaining. But I hate grinding, that's why I play on easy mode. Because, I mean, you can... God damn. Damn it. Oh, one moment, guys. Yes?
I'm gonna take a shower.
Okay. Alright, Sorry about that. I don't remember. Excuse me. Anyway. So, yeah, that's why I play uneasy. I know some of you are probably like, it's boring watching someone play uneasy because everything is too easy, but I mostly play games for the story. And if you'd like a challenge, by all means, play on a harder level. I'm not, on top of, you know, just preferring to get through a game quickly, Birth by Sleep is actually one of my least favorite games in the Kingdom Hearts series, so that's another reason why I play it on an easier level. Although I will be playing all of them on an easy level because I'm working full time now, and my time is limited. I don't really have time to get good at a game well enough to play on the more difficult levels. If I did that, you wouldn't see updates hardly at all. Fucking bitches. How hard is it to die? Seriously. Oh wow, already up to level 26. There you go. I've gained 3 levels already. Gotcha. Thunder. Freeze. There we go. But anyway, yeah. Majorly fuck, I got turned around. Ah. Yeah. Trick. I better not have ended up turning around. I swear to God, if I ended up going the wrong way, I'm gonna be pissed. I love having a bunch of swords. They're just awesome. Alright. Let's hope this is the right way because I get the feeling that I might have turned around. If I ended up turning around, I'm going to be so fucking pissed. Pray that I didn't get turned around. Ha! Made it. And there were question marks, which means I did go in the right direction. Yay! And we're gonna save. And so, because I'm going up into the final portion of the game, I'm just gonna focus on... Wonderful. I'm gonna focus on a distance. So, we're gonna take And now I got back. Alright, let's melt some and see if we can... Thunder Surge. Sure, we'll go with this one. Spark Raid. So throwing the Keyblade will probably work, and then this one would actually be pretty good to have. Poke the Keyblade in ice and throw it at the enemy. And then that one. Okay. Okay, I think we're pretty good, I hope. I'm hoping. We're gonna save again so that we don't have to do all that over again. But I did manage to gain several levels, so that's something. And you know, if it's not enough, I can always go back to that land of cyclones and just level up some more. Off screen, of course, because I'm not making anyone sit through that. And, you know, before we head on, we're reaching pretty close to the end point that I would have for a typical video. So I'm going to cut it short today. So thank you for watching, and I will see you.